Secretary of the Education of British Cultural Online Class. I'm Omorebe Ellis, your English teacher, and we'll be going through the second topic, do's and don'ts of summary writing. In the previous class, I told you the next video would treat this topic in practical. So now let's look at it. Do's and don'ts of summary. First, read the passage thoroughly before attempting the questions. Yes, you cannot attempt a question when you have not actually understood the passage. Read it thoroughly before you start attempting the questions. Secondly, you should be able to state the ideas in such sentences without quoting them word for word. That's why it is good you are used to your vocabulary. Even when you want to summarize a writer's idea, it is good you use your own words. Do not include words that are not relevant. Yes, in summary writing, it is not necessary. You don't have to start telling us stories. Go straight to the point. Use few words intelligently from the original passage without copying every word, just like point two. Underline the sentences which are important for the summary. Yes, while you are trying to summarize the passage, always take note of the sentences that you will make reference to in your answers. Divide the text into paragraphs. Yes, this is essential when you are making your own summary passage. Ensure you divide your text into paragraphs. Don't just write in one paragraph, except you are asked to give the summary in one paragraph. Now write down keywords which are important for the summary. As you are reading, you notice that there's a word you want to actually expatiate on. Write it down. If necessary, transform direct speech into reported speech only if there is an important idea in it. When you say direct speech, since you are summarizing, you are not going to make use of a reported speech rather than the direct speech, because you are not directly quoting the passage. How to answer summary questions. Yes, this is very important. Like the previous slide talked about how you can write a summary passage. Now, you are going to state how you can answer your summary questions. Now, you have been given questions to answer in your comprehension, and you are asked to give summary. Now, first, you read the questions, which is very important. You don't go outside the given passage. Even when you have an idea about the topic, don't go outside what was stated in that passage. Try to summarize the content of each paragraph in your own words. Every paragraph has a topic sentence. So, if you are very good in summary, you should be able to summarize each content in that paragraph. Quickly run through the summary of each paragraph. Answer the questions by deleting wrong options. There are some times you are reading and you just feel, no, this is not part of what I'm looking for. That is good. Just delete them. Go straight. Look for the idea in that paragraph. Doing a quick review of answer sheets is very important. While you are done, it is good you quickly review your answer sheet. What have you answered? Try to link it to the questions. But don't try to memorize each and every part of the passage. Do not try to memorize each and every part of the passage. Yes, it is good you read a passage, but don't try to assume that you know what the passage is saying when you have not read it. Okay, practical example. If you are asked to write a summary on the topic examination malpractice, that's why we are not using our reading test, but this is a practical example extracted from a reading test. You are now asked to write a summary on the topic examination malpractice. One, ask yourself questions that will lead to outlining the reading passage. If your questions are answered in the passage, you have the main ideas. Yes, you have been asked to write this topic. These are questions you ask yourself. Why do you want to outline the passage? First, what is examination malpractice? What are the causes of examination malpractice? How is it done? Who are the people involved? These are questions that you should ask yourself while you intend to apply the passage. We'll answer it in the next slide. In applying the main point from the passage, this is the step we must follow. One, definition. What is examination malpractice? It is stated here, examination malpractice is a deliberate wrongdoing contrary to official examination rules. What are its causes? One, students do not prepare for the exam. Examination officers are corrupt. Societal pressure on teachers, students, and parents. These actually have answered this question, causes of examination malpractice, without necessarily adding irrelevant details. You have just gone straight to the point to tell us what are its causes. Now, how is it done? That's the perpetration. Prepared answers brought into the hall. Teachers or examiners falsifying results. You can see that these points were just brought out. This is the main idea, the question you are asking. These are the points supporting the question. Now, who are those that take part in malpractice? The students, the teachers, the parents, the examination officers. This is a practical example of making a summary of your own. If you are given a question like that, then if you are given a passage to answer, you make you. Now, in conclusion, if you must read and understand what summary involves, first you know the meaning of words, that's your vocabulary, ability to understand the meaning of a word given in a passage, ability to follow a position of passage, answer your questions, ability to recognize the literary devices used in a passage. These are actually things that you cannot escape when you are answering your comprehension passages. So take note of these ideas, have it at the back of your mind, and whatever question you have been asked on summary, you can actually answer them. See you in the next class. Have a good day.